Shu and friends in Storytime Adventures. Cha-Cha had a new toy car.
Vroom, vroom! I'm going to have fun playing with my new car.
Custly came by. He took the car from Cha-Cha.
I'm taking your car, Cha-Cha. I want to play with it.
Wait, Custly, no!
Choo-Choo heard Cha-Cha and came to see what had happened.
What's wrong, Cha-Cha? Why are you so upset? Custly took my toy car away, Choo-Choo. Cheer up, Cha-Cha. No one can take what is yours if you're smart. We'll surely get your car back. But first, let me tell you the story of how Jack got his magical bowl back.
A magical bowl? Please tell me the story, Choo-Choo.
And so, Choo-Choo began to tell Cha-Cha a story.
Long, long ago, there lived a boy named Jack. He lived with his sister, whose name was Jill. Jack was poor, but he was very kind. He helped everyone he met.
Here, birds. I have some breadcrumbs for you.
Jack had a friend named Joe. One day, Joe asked Jack to go with him to the neighboring town.
Will you come with me, Jack? I need some help carrying some bags. And bring your lunch with you, too. We won't be back until evening.
Okay, Joe.
Jack and Jill hardly had any food. And so, Jack made himself a sandwich with some cheese and dry bread. He brought the sandwich in a bag for his lunch. Bye, Jack!
Bye!
At lunchtime, Jack and Joe sat under a tree. Jack took out his simple sandwich. Joe had a basket full of delicious things.
I've got a sandwich.
I've got cakes, fruits, jams, jellies, breads, pies, and lemonade.
Just then, a girl passed by. She looked very poor.
I'm so hungry. I wish I had something to eat. Even a tiny crumb would be good.
Joe ignored the girl and went on eating. But Jack decided to give his sandwich to the girl.
She looks so poor and hungry. She must need my sandwich more than I do. Hello? Wait! Please, take my sandwich.
The girl took Jack's sandwich. And then, something very magical happened. The girl's ragged clothes turned into fine silken ones. Her dusty hair shimmered and shined like gold. And the girl turned into a fairy.
Huh? You're a fairy!
Yes, Jack, I'm a fairy. Thank you for sharing your lunch with me. I'd like to give you something, too. Please, take this bowl.
A bowl?
Yes, it's a magical bowl. Hold it carefully each morning and say, "Magic."
magical bowl. Magical bowl. Please give me a coin made of gold. If you do that, the bowl will give you a shining gold coin.
Thank you.
Jack woke up early the next morning.
Did I really meet a fairy yesterday? Or was I just dreaming? I wasn't dreaming. The magical bowl is right here. I must do what the fairy told me to. Magical bowl, please give me a coin made of gold. Hooray! I have a gold coin.
Jack was very happy. He showed Jill the magical bowl and the gold coin.
We aren't going to be poor anymore, Jill. This bowl is magical. It's going to give us gold coins and make us rich. Hooray!
Jack went and bought food for Jill and himself. He also bought some gifts for Joe.
These gifts are for you, Joe. Thank you for taking me with you yesterday.
Huh? The next morning, Jack asked the magical bowl for a gold coin again.
Magical bowl, please give me a coin made of gold.
And the magical bowl gave Jack a gold coin again.
Hooray!
Over time, Jack grew very rich because of the gold coins. Joe was very curious to know how.
Jack, where did you get all these gold coins from? Did you find a treasure? Come on, tell me. I'm your best friend.
A fairy gave me this magical bowl, Joe. All I do is hold it every morning and say, magical bowl, please give me a coin made of gold. See?
Huh?
Joe was very greedy. He decided to steal the magical bowl. And when Jack wasn't looking, he took it away.
Hello, Jill.
When Jack couldn't find the magical bowl, he grew worried.
Huh? My magical bowl is missing, Jill. Where could it go? Only you and Joe knew about it.
Joe must have stolen the magical bowl. I saw him hiding something when he was leaving.
Oh, no!
Don't worry, Jack. The magical bowl is yours. We'll get it back from Joe. Jack and Jill then went and bought a new bowl that looked exactly like the magical bowl. Now listen carefully. You must show this bowl to Joe and tell him that it's magical too and that it gives a dozen gold coins instead of one. So Jack showed the new bowl to Joe.
Joe, guess what? I met the fairy again. She gave me another magical bowl. This bowl gives a dozen gold coins instead of one.
A dozen gold coins? Wow!
Yes, Joe, but please don't tell anyone about it. It's a secret.
Joe was very greedy, and he wanted the new bowl.
I will replace Jack's new magical bowl with this old one I took. That way, he won't notice the new one is missing. Because if he knows it's missing, he'll know that I have taken it.
So, when Jack wasn't looking, Joe switched the magical bowls in Jack's house, taking the new one instead.
Hooray! We have our magical bowl back! Joe left it here and took the new bowl instead.
Let's take extra special care of the magic bowl now and never show it to anyone. As for Joe, every day he asked the new bowl again and again for gold, but the bowl never produced anything.
Magical bowl, please give me a dozen coins made of gold. Magical bowl, please give me a dozen coins made of gold.
Magical bowl,
please give me a dozen coins made of gold.
So you see, Cha-Cha, no one can take your things away if you are smart. Come on now, let's get your toy car back from Cusley.
What's happening? Where is the car going? Yow!
Nicky was a boy who lived near the lake. He was very worried about the lake.
Huh? What a shock! The little goat got when he entered the cave.
Sammy, why don't you paint the outside of my house? I will pay you for that.
You used the peanuts I gave you very wisely. You planted them and made them grow.